Hey friends, welcome back. Thank you so much for being here. So in today's video, I am very, very excited because I am going to be sharing my top 15 purchases from 2020 at Sephora. So if you're interested and you love luxury makeup, you want to go ahead and click that red button that says subscribe. And also go ahead and follow me on my Instagram because I do share new makeup styles, makeup releases, everything like that. So go ahead and follow me there. Without further ado, let's start, friends, and let's get started. And I am very excited, you guys. I'm very excited. We're wrapping 2020. It is a time for this weird year to be finished, to be over, and I am excited to share my faves of the year. So this time around, we're going to talk about all the purchases that I did at Sephora and which are my top 15 picks. I've seen top 10, but I couldn't narrow it to 10, you guys. Most of my purchases I do from Sephora because if I purchase from the retailer directly, I usually get charged customs. If you're Canadian, you know the struggle. But yeah, so I purchased all of my things from Sephora, which meant that this was extremely, extremely hard to do. But yeah, I managed to do 15. I have some makeup, I have one skincare, and I have a scent, and I have, yeah. So just randomness all together. These are my top 15 in no particular order. Let's get started. One of my best purchases of 2020 is gotta be this one by Tatcha. This is the Liquid Silk Canvas Primer. And if you have been a subscriber of mine, then you already know this. I love this stuff. I stopped using it when the weather got a little bit too cool, but I started using it again. Only use this guy on my T-zone, and I try not to put it around my mouth because that's where I get the most dryness, and it tend to look a little bit weird. But this is an amazing primer. It just makes you look like a doll. Very perfected and beautiful. I just love the texture. I love how perfected it is. It really covers your pores, and it makes an amazing canvas truly for any foundation at top. So this was my favorite primer of 2020, and I purchased it from Sephora. Another hit from Sephora was a Patrick Ta collection, and I'm putting them together because I did purchase them together. So I do have here Ortiz Single, his lipstick, and I just love his lipsticks, you guys. The formula of these ones are so, so amazing. This is like the perfect, most perfect nude ever. The formula is really nice. It is a velvety kind of like lippy. It is a matte formula, but extremely, extremely comfortable. This is one of those orangey reds that look just stunning for summertime. So the orange is just not from here, and the nude is Ortiz Single. I love these lipsticks, and along with the lipsticks, I did buy his blushes. This is the Double Take Cream and Powder Brush in Chiso LA, and this is one of those cream and powder products by him. This is just amazing, you guys. This is one of my favorite products of 2020. This is just extremely long lasting, long wearing, very pretty. If you want only the cream, you can do the cream and it gives you a pretty glow. You can mix them together or not. This is just stunning. This is my favorite shade, and this is the one that I wanted to share with you. But yeah, this is a favorite for sure at Sephora. When it comes to foundation, one of the best ones that I tried this year is this one by Tom Ford. This is his Traceless Matte Foundation, and this is a beautiful soft matte perfecting foundation. It looks extremely beautiful on your complexion. You pretty much look poreless and like a doll. And that's my preferred kind of finish. I love Mi Sun foundation, and this gotta be one of my faves. It just looks beautiful all day long, extremely long wearing. If you set it down with powder, it lasts even more. If you don't, then you're gonna get a glow by 5-6 hours, but it looks so natural and beautiful. This is one of my faves by Tom Ford, period. But yeah, these I discovered in 2020 and I did want it to share. Another beautiful release by Pat McGrath, and these I'm counting as one as well because I purchased them together, is Pat's Sublime Perfecting Concealer. and her setting powder, her under eye setting powder. So I do have the shade medium, and this is making a little bit of a mess because it is just so finely milled, you guys. This is pretty much undetectable. It is the softest powder that you're going to ever touch. I just love it. I love it for underneath my eyes. I love it for all over my face. I love it with a beauty sponge. I tap at this powder with a dampen, like a previously dampen and beauty sponge, and you just look poreless and beautiful. This is an amazing setting powder altogether. I just love it. I loved it ever since I tried it, and so this is a fave for sure. And then the concealer, this is my third, I think it is my third concealer tube. I love it. I use the shade LM14 with this concealer. I don't really have to correct my dark circles. I just, it lasts a ton, it doesn't crease, it doesn't look creepy. These two together are amazing. This shade actually lets me do underneath my eyes and all over my face. So it is such a multitasker concealer. I just love it. Another product by Tom Ford that I discovered in 2020 is their shade and illuminate. I have intensity one, and these I'm mentioning it because I purchased from Sephora. This is an older product, but it was new to me in 2020. So here you have a bronzer and of course those balms, highlighting products. This is just gonna give you a pretty glow, and then this bronzer is just everything to me. I love it. I love the tone of it. I love how easy it is to apply, to diffuse. It looks really beautiful. It lets you contour, bronze. It is everything. It is everything. I love this compact. It is so beautiful presentation. I mean, what else can I say? One of my faves for sure. Number six, an Hourglass palette. This is their holiday palette, and this is in Sculptor. I had brain freeze. So this is what this one looks like. I love every single powder in this compact. Everything works on my complexion. Even the two lightest shades I use for underneath my eyes. I love the highlighter. I love the blushes, especially this one for fall and like winter. It's so pretty. This is an existing blush and people love it. I think it's Mood Sculpture. Yeah. And then the bronzer is a beautiful, deep enough for my medium to tan complexion, and it's just an amazing palette. Next up, we have an eye palette, and this one is by Dior. This is their reformulated quince. This is in the shade Mitza, and this, I'm not talking about specifically this one, but this is one of my faves. I purchased, I believe it was No Dress or Jungle. I can't remember which one I purchased first, but ever since, it's been love at first sight. I just love every single of this palette. Slowly but surely, I've been collecting them all because they're just amazing. I've reviewed this one. If you want to take a look, I'll link it above. But these are just stunning. As I said, this is like my kind of colors. Like for every day, this shade is stunning. These two are very soft and classic. These I just find very, very soft and sophisticated. I can't really get enough of them. So yeah, this is one of my Sephora faves. Hello, girlin'. You know that was coming, right? I've talked about this foundation so much. I just can't stop, you guys. This is Guerlain's L'Essentiel foundation. This is a 93% natural foundation. It smells really weird, but I don't mind. It smells like tea or like herbs. I don't mind it. The scent really, it goes away. I do have the shade 04W, which is a tiny bit too dark for me, but I manage. I love it. I love this foundation. It is a 16-hour foundation, and it is indeed that to me. It wears beautiful when I wear it. It's extremely natural. It is a foundation that I could rely on to be pretty the whole time. So I love this one by Guerlain. I do highly recommend. I do correct my dark circles, and my favorite this year was this discovery by Bobbi Brown. This is her corrector in the shade medium to dark bisque. I love it. I just use it every time I do my makeup. I'm wearing it today. I use it, you know, underneath every single concealer. Some sometimes I don't if I'm using my pad, but if I'm using any other concealer, I usually correct my dark circles. It's a beautiful, beautiful corrector. I love the formula. It has a ton of coverage and I can't get enough. A beautiful lipstick, a formula that I've fallen in love with is this one's by Gucci. My fave is Painted Veil, but it is in my purse and I'm not feeling like going there and pick it up. But this is another beautiful that I purchased over on summertime. This is in the shade The Matte in Argentina. And this is just a beautiful warm tone color. I love it, you guys. I love the formula. It has a really strong scent, I'm not gonna lie. It goes away maybe in half an hour or so. Sometimes it tends to linger some days more than others. So I love the matte formulation, not the flatting too much. I love the matte better. These are super long lasting, a very comfortable, creamy on the, you know, on the lips. And yeah, I do love these ones. Another concealer that I have to mention is this one by Jouer. This is their high coverage essential concealer. I've talked about this concealer so much. This is the one that I'm wearing today in the shade Creme Brulee. I do have Honey Creme Brulee, and I keep repurchasing this concealer. I discovered it in 2020. It isn't a new concealer by Jouer. I believe it's one of, they have only two, and this is one of them. I love it. I just love it. It is extremely full coverage. It covers absolutely everything. When I want to look extra glam like today, I did use it. And yeah, I do love this one. Another product that deserves so, so much hype is this one by YSL. I don't know if you guys remember when I did my review on this one. This is the 3D All Over Glow powder. This is meant to be like a finishing powder, but I love it, you guys. I wear it as a last step at the end, like I'll do the buffing technique. Love the natural glow that it gives my complexion. I don't know if you're gonna be able to see it, but for sure I can see it. I didn't have it before, and it just gives you such a beautiful and healthy glow. It is so, so finely milled. I love this powder. This was one of my favorite purchases ever from 2020, and I don't think I give it too much love on camera. This is coming out on my faves for sure, but yeah, these I purchased from Sephora. I think it was around summertime, and I just love it. A product that I just repurchased in love 2020 is Olaplex number 3 Hair Perfector. I've talked about this product. I bought backups during the sale. I just keep repurchasing, and I did wanted to mention this product for the hair because it's just amazing. I use it before I go into the shower. So I dampen my hair with like squeezy, like a bottle with water. So I just dampen my hair a little bit. I put that on, I comb my hair, and I leave it for an hour or two, and then I jump into the shower. It's just amazing. If you color treat your hair, it makes your hair very strong and pretty, and I just can't get enough of that Olaplex system. So number 3 is 100% my favorite. I need to mention one skincare product that I love from Sephora and that I purchased this year. It's gonna be the Tatcha Rice Cleanser. Oh my god, you guys, this is just an amazing, gentle but yet exfoliating kind of cleanser. I just love it. I love it. I ran through it so, so quick. I bought it during the sell. I needed to mention it because it's just an amazing product. It, as I said, is extremely gentle. I do have the rice powder, like the regular rice thingy. And that one you mix with water. This one is the better version. It is done for you. It is in a cleanser, all done for you. You just massage it over your face, and it's just an amazing cleanser by Tatcha. So that's gotta be my fave skincare product that I purchased from Sephora. Last but not least, Ascend and Hypnotic Poison by Dior. I mentioned these during my faves last month. I just can't get enough, you guys. I am drawn to that scent so, so much. I find it to be so comforting and beautiful and pretty and just cuddly, and it is sweet, but it is so delicate. It is sexy. I wear it to bed. So I love to wear it at night. Like if I want, to smell really nice for myself, it becomes a very private scent, which I love. My skin, it is extremely private and I just love to go to bed with it. It's just so comforting. I love it. I do highly recommend if you like a little bit of a sweet scent, but not overpowering at all. It has a little bit of vanilla. It is just extremely soothing and beautiful. I love it. I didn't bring the bottle, but I'll post the picture. I just love that scent. I needed to mention that. And that's a wrap, you guys. Those were my top 15 faves from Sephora. Let me know what are yours. I would love to know your top, I don't know, one, two. Just drop me your fave that you purchased from Sephora. Thanks so much, you guys, for love and support. Don't forget to share, like, and subscribe, and I'll catch you next time. Bye.